Ask yourself, what is it that unique people do when they want to hear an interesting perspective? They tune into the mind of Gary, the quirky podcast for the out-of-the-box thinkers that provide the mind with feel-good moments. And now, he, himself, the king of ridiculous thoughts, your host, Gary. Welcome, good people of the day. On today, in my mind, I feel like we should talk about color. But not the color of your skin, because I think that's... we've talked about that a lot, and we need to continue to talk about that. But let's also look at it from a different angle, and let's talk about the affiliation of color in our lives. But first, let's give thanks to the Almighty Jesus Himself. I love that track. It just feels so good to me. All right, so as always, let's define it. What is color? Again, we're not talking about pigmentation. That's one definition. But the definition we are talking about is the property possessed by an object of producing different sensations on the eyes as a result of the way the object reflects or emits light. So essentially, the way light comes through a mirror and comes out on the other side. Yeah, I had to take it back on you. For those in my age bracket, you know what this is. So the rainbow is made up of seven colors. You have red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. And every one of those colors are the basic colors. And every color after that is a version of those initial seven colors, or a combination of a multiple of at least two or more of those seven colors, right? So you have those seven colors. If you say that you like fuchsia, fuchsia is a version of pink, but it's still pink, right? So that's what I mean when I say a combination or a version. And we just, you know, like, again, I'm just in my own space right now. I'm in my own head. I'm in my own mind. There's no guest today, but I thought this was important to talk about and just show proof that, you know, we have ideas. So whatever in your head, just let that go. Right? All around the beats. Just get me pumped up a little bit before I start going into these definitions. So we've talked about the seven colors that make up the rainbow, the seven basic colors. But now let's talk about the adjectives that describe these seven colors. So yellow. Yellow is joy, happiness, betrayal, optimism, idealism, imagination, hope, dishonesty, friendship, hazard. When you look at a sign, when you look at a hazard sign, what color is it? It is yellow. When you look at a friendship bracelet, what color is it? It's yellow. When you look at a Lance Armstrong, Live Strong bracelet, what is it? It's yellow. It means hope, right? So imagination, if you're an imaginative person, if you're an optimistic person, if you're a person of betrayal, you probably like yellow. Red, excitement, energy, passion, power, sincerity, danger, speed, war. Now, this is interesting because red has a lot of things going on here. So if I pull out the word war, I can see how red can be correlated to war, because you've got a lot of bloodshed has to do with war. But the in danger, right? Passion, but not power. I didn't think red had to do with power. I wouldn't have picked red to do with excitement, right? Or red to do with speed, because, you know, when I look at a speeding sign, most speed limits are white and black. But a stop sign is red, which is the opposite of speeding. Interesting. Think about this. Ponder these things. Blue is the third color. Peace, calm, cold, stability, unity, trust, technology, appetite, loyalty, confidence, trust, cleanliness. Blue is an interesting color here because you have the person who is peaceful, or you can have the cold person, but I don't think it means cold as a personality trait. I think it means cold as in physically cold, right? Why do your fingers turn blue when they're cold? Calm, stability, unity, trust, technology, appetite. I like that one, the appetite one. So essentially, if you want to curve somebody's mind, parents, so for parents and restaurant owners out there, if you want to trick your children into, try this, let's see if it work. This works. If you want to trick your children into eating the meal, put their food on a blue plate and see if it builds their appetite or allows them to eat more because they think that their appetite is larger than it actually is. But I'm not condoning obesity, by no means. All right, so the fourth one is orange. Orange is energy, balance, warmth, expansive, flamboyant, demanding, attention, vibrant, enthusiasm. Now, also, I want you to think about these colors as which color would represent you. Are you a yellow person? Are you a red? Are you blue? Are you orange? I myself, I'm going to have to stick with the orange because I can see myself being or wanting to be energetic, balanced, warm, expansive, flamboyant, demanding attention, vibrant, enthusiasm, right? How about you? Interesting. Green, next color. I want to, fifth color, green, nature. We know it. We know nature goes with green. Environment, healthy, good luck, renewal, youth, generosity, jealousy, service, and envy. The one there I would pick out would probably be good luck, because I wonder if good luck means, and you tell me if this is ridiculous or if this is just in my mind, does good luck have anything to do with us using green pieces of paper as value and as money to determine good luck? When you have good luck, what do we say? Most of the time we say you get money, you're lucky. When you go to the casinos, you're lucky. And when you're lucky, usually you win money. And if you look at the service, the military, what color are their uniforms mostly? Green. Nice. Next color is indigo. I want to say indigo is a combination. It's powerful. It's dignified. It means integrity. It means deep sincerity. It means devotion. It means wisdom. It means justice. It means fairness. I believe indigo is a darker version or a purple version. And that's interesting because usually when royalty wears purple or a form of indigo or blue, I think indigo is blue and purple put together, not sure, but power and dignified, wisdom, justice, devotion. And the last color is violet. So yes, I'm right. Indigo is the combination between blue and violet, but violet represents the future, imagination, dreams, spiritual enlightenment. So there's two. So the seven colors. You have all these different descriptions, and so I challenge you to ask yourself, which color are you? Look at your personality. Are you the person that is more like yellow, joyous, happy, betray, optimism, idealism, imagination? Are you red? Are you blue? Are you orange? Are you green? Are you indigo? Or are you violet? Or you could be a combination of any of those. Look at your kids. What are your kids? Are they a combination of any of those? The point of this topic today is to really just kind of look at the psychology of how can we think different about color. And this is the way. And I just can't let go of the idea that it means that much to our lives. And you know how I like to do things. This is Epic the Don. Thank you for the beats. Can't let go. You see how I did that? But we just changing up the rhythm here. I like what I'm doing. And you should too. You should really just think about what kind of person you want to be and how you can do everything possible in your life to define yourself. How do you want to represent yourself? And you can start with the colors that you choose to surround yourself with. All right, so now that we've talked about the actual descriptions of color, now we want to discuss What are those benefits? What are the benefits or the psychological benefits of these colors? Interesting. First point to know is that the same color can also have different meanings that are dependent on your upbringing, your gender, your location, values, and variety of other factors. So that means the colors that you love. When someone asks you, what's your favorite color? And you have a color in mind, because most people should have one color, a variation of one color. But some people say they have two or three favorite colors, which you probably don't. But one is your absolute favorite. And that is dependent on your upbringing. It's interesting. And it says it's dependent on your gender as well. But I kind of feel like that might be defined, right? We tell our little girls, oh, you should wear, you know, pink is your color. Pink, pink, pink. We tell our little boys blue, 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 blue. But why? Who chose that? Who said that blue has to be boys? Who said that pink has to be girls, right? So an example of this would be the wall colors that you choose in your office, in your home, right? Wall colors, we say white wall colors makes the house feel bigger. We say, but if you put color in your house, if you put green walls, burgundy walls, it makes the house feel warm, right? And if you go to funerals, why do we wear black to go to funerals? Why does black mean death? Why does black supposedly absorb sunlight? All these things have meaning. But the main focus is to understand is that color is a form of communicating. Color is unbeatable. It's unconscious or otherwise. Color can evoke emotions. It can inspire reactions. It can change moods of thinking. When you give your woman or someone flowers on Valentine's Day and they're not red, that determines a reaction or inspires a reaction. It also evokes an emotion depending on what color you give them. You give red flowers, they think that you love them. You give white flowers, they think that you're just being friendly, right? And it can excite or soothe the mood. It can raise or lower your blood pressure or even vet your appetite. We've talked about this before earlier when blue is appetite. So whether it's innate or learned, it's undeniable that color has a vital impact on how we go about our lives. That is the harsh reality and unspoken truth. But I am on it today, and I'm just glad to be in a positive space here with my white hoodie on, looking around as I look around my space and I look at what colors. I'm all the way on it today, but let's take a little meditation pause. Listen to some. This is Jasmine Sullivan and Ari Lennox, just to keep the mood right. I love these type of songs because they're just so mellow, right? Music and color go together. Change the mood. Feel the mood. The vibrations. And this is Colors by Black Puma. We're just going to take you up and down for a couple of minutes and let you just kind of zone out and think about what we've discussed already. What kind of color are you? What color are you? But not your skin. I woke up to you the morning. What is your favorite color? That's my question to you. Baby blue, just like me it hurts. Are you baby blue? When I get up off this ground, I shake leaves back down to the brown, 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 till I'm clean. So that is Black Puma, Colors, and yeah, that's just the mood we was in. We had to take a little mood break. So let's list it. These are the 8 reasons why color matters to you in your day. Number 1, color plays a vital important role in the world in which we live. Number 2, color can sway your thinking. Absolutely. If you are wearing black and you know that black means death, you're going to feel like death. Okay. Number 3, color changes your actions. Absolutely. Number 4, color causes reactions, as we said before with the flowers. With jewelry. Color can change your reaction with jewelry, right? If you like silver, someone gives you gold, it's not the value, it's the color. Number 5, it can irritate or soothe your eyes. Why do they sell us black light glasses for your computers? Why do they tell you don't stare at your computers or your cell phones or your tablets or your TVs too long? Because visually, it's just made up of a bunch of different colors that can be harmful to your eyes. So yes, color can irritate or soothe your eyes, right? You can also look at a black screen. It's supposed to be healthier for your eyes than a color screen. Number six, color can raise your blood pressure or suppress your appetite. That was seven. Number eight, when used in the right way, color can even save on energy consumption, right? Let's think about solar panels. How are solar panels made up? They're made up of a bunch of little mirrors that reflect and absorb light. It absorbs the light, transfers it, and sends it back out as energy. But it absorbs light from the sun. The sun is giving off color, an energy source. Orange energy. Remember? Color is very important in our life if we really, really, really just think about it. It's like numbers. Everything comes down to numbers, colors, and a bunch of other things. Which is why I wanted to talk about it today, because it was just in my mind. Before I go, I wanted to thank you for listening to my show today. And I know we didn't have a guest, but this is just what I wanted to do today because I thought it was important for me to just kind of allow you to enter the space in which I was living. And sometimes it's good to just reflect to yourself, man, you know? And I hope that you've learned at least one thing today from what I've spoken on. And I challenge you, before I let you go, I challenge you to ask yourself, am I closer to a red person, a blue person, a green kind of person, a violet kind of person? Look it up. Decide what you want to be. Choose your color or find your color and exploit that color. Give that color meaning, because color is a power which directly influences the soul. That is your quote by Wassily Kandinsky. Color is a power which directly influences the soul. And please remember that if you have learned anything today, I would be grateful if you share this with someone and just let them know that you were in the mind of Gary. Have a blessed day and be great. Thank you for tuning into the mind of Gary. Be sure to share the thoughts you heard today. And most of all, be blessed, be sure, be you. Until the next time, be great.